I speak the word, Tofanah is in the form of a story. And that's what I have for you today, a story. Now all of us, we have a love life. And many of us have a hate life. And today my story will be about my hate life. I started off big, hating great inevitable things. Death was first. At age 4, my life was perfectly circular and contained like a candy tin. The days had no end, and forever was just the way things were. So when my grandmother died one afternoon, I refused to accept death as the reason for her disappearance. This magical vanishing made no sense to me, and the possibility of getting erased like that scared me mad. After a few weeks, under persuasion, I gave in to the popular insistence on the fact of death and grimly hated it until at the age of 6 I began to hate sex. At that time, my mother enjoyed the status of the wisest, purest, most wonderful person I ever knew. And when a friend of mine told me what she had to do to get me, that really pissed me off. The friend got the information on sex from some older boys, and I was quite mad at the friend, so I beat him up a bit. But the older boys deserve worse. So I decided that under special circumstances, death was okay, and I made my peace with it. I mean, my world was expanding, and I started realizing that I also hated people. My mother, my few friends, and were the inherent part of my life, and I hated to share it with all those people out there. The people who refused to understand us and had ideas about life that I consider offensive, they seem to unanimously accept practice of sex as not only reasonable, but even desirable. And for this, I felt they deserved nothing less than death. Repugnant and terrifying, death was good, since it was the only way of dealing with all the people who were into sex and started to tease me because of my race. The dark blood running through my 6-year-old veins came from a delta far away in distance and time, making me a part of an evil tribe of people whose place was in the bottom of the shit pile in my world. I hated my blood. When my blood inheritance was revealed to me, I had to face the life of someone different from all the people I hated. I revolted and refused to have any part in my race. I insisted that I was just like everyone else, and anyone suggesting otherwise deserves sex or death or worse. My mother explained to me that this was yet another matter in which I had no choice. Grimly, I accepted my racial circumstances with the earnest, profound hatred that dwells inside those who feel karmically fucked over. Since I was not sure how to bring either sex or death to my offenders, I just went on hating them. Around that time, I had entered school, and with it, a new realm of hate. In school, I began scaling down on the magnitude of my hate, but managed to maintain inevitability as a constant. For starters, my school was full of boys much bigger than I, who showed me my ethnic place by beating me up for it. I hated them for that, and beat up those I could. The others beat me up for that, or because they knew I hated them, and a large part of my childhood was spent involved in beatings with continuously changing perspective. There were classes I hated, and teachers who taught them. This involved most classes and most teachers. German and physical education had the largest part of the hate cake. My main problem with the physical ed was that I was large and clumsy and not very good at it. Badly coordinated and shy, I resembled a seal begging for fish during any given exercise and felt that the teachers put me through it simply for entertainment value. I hated the teacher of German because she expected me to memorize the long, queer, hateful German words and seemed to enjoy my traumatic refusal to learn anything. Most classes posed similar problems. I hated school and felt that school hated me. Adolescence arrived, bringing in it new hate, modest in scope but ambitious in range. The two subjects which were all the hate's range in those days were most girls, who did not like me, and myself, for being unliked. My problems with myself were mostly physical. Dark skin, curly hair, skinny arms, and nothing seemed to promise any reprise from it. I grew up surrounded by lanky Slavic proletarian kids who spent all their time engaged in a variety of team sports and collaborative late-night vandalism. I participated in vandalism to the extent that I could, but as a result of my school-long hate of physical education, the team sports were completely out of the question. At that time, the Russian Mick Jagger look was what made hearts throb throughout the female contingent of my school. My Semitic looks, gangly manner, and my inability to keep my eye on the ball made me seem weird to girls, and not the good kind of weird. So I hated girls for not liking me, especially because around that time, I definitely stopped hating sex. Much of my adolescence was involved spent reading romantic literature. So my view of life had changed radically. Sex, definitely book approved, and suddenly desperately necessary, was positively a good thing. People were acceptable, since according to books, they were complex and allowed to occasionally stray from the ideal. Death was terrific. Death was the grand reward. No matter how bad things got, there was always a chance death would fix it. Going to German class, I pictured a teacher erased by plunging, crushing, fiery socialist realist death. Coming back, I'd be lost in my own romantic death of a tragic hero never understood by the world. Even though my hate, sorry about that, man. You want me to stop? I'll stop. Second part next time.
So definitely come on January 3rd.